Welcome to the March 2017 edition of Farsight's Time Cross Project, where we use remote viewing to report the news to you the month before the major news events happen. I am Courtney Brown, director of the Farsight Institute, and in this video, we present raw news predictions for March 2017. Now, all of these predictions are based on remote viewing done and uploaded to YouTube for all to see in February 2017. Now, this is a public remote viewing experiment, and we are using remote viewing to transfer perceptual information across time and space. Now, I want to encourage everyone watching to also watch our summary video that describes how our remote viewers did in predicting and reporting the news for last month, February 2017. Now, that summary video will be published around March 10th, so be sure to look for it. Thus, we publish two Time Cross videos a month that you will want to see, the raw news predictions and the results summary. Now on to our predictions for March 2017. We have three remote viewers working this month, Dick Alkire, Princess Janae, and Aziz Brown. So in that order, here is the news for March 2017, published in February 2017. Note that each viewer covers at least two major news events for the month.
This is Time Cross for March 2017. Today is February 26th, Sunday. I did a little work on this yesterday and the day before yesterday, and now I'm going to present it all at once. I dropped out of this project last October for the November prediction because at that time, what I called it was like a disturbance in the force. And I'm kind of feeling the same thing now. It's like things really seem to be in flux. When I try to look ahead at events, it just feels really, really noisy. I think things are happening. Big things are about to happen. This is tough as a remote viewer. This whole project is kind of like trying to row across the Atlantic Ocean in a squall in a rowboat. It's not easy. So I'll give it my best here. This, I'm calling this target 2HHM-2NHB. 2HHM-2NHB, which is cued to a significant news event or events that will be happening in March. In my preliminary work, I want to show you a couple things here at the whiteboard. First thing I saw was a water event, gushing water, forceful flowing, a wall of water under great pressure, a water event. And I'm gonna get into this in some depth in a full session, but that's the first thing that struck me working this target. A couple of other things, because as I'm looking, images come in, man, I can't get rid of this. Images come to me, they flicker in and out. They kind of come and go, and one of the things I saw was I'm in outer space. I see a star field. The curvature of Earth over here. And I recognize this as like the International Space Station. You know, like the solar panels here and pieces. And there's another piece over here. So I felt pretty sure that I was looking at the International Space Station here. And what about it? Well, I think it's going to make news, and there will be some images and some news stories about this. Why? When I looked at it, I got a feeling of it being in two parts or two pieces. And I don't think that, I'm not sure that necessarily means that the thing is broken apart, but just that there are two distinct parts of it. Like maybe they had a problem here. They're going to have a problem with electrical fire, loss of hull pressure, computer malfunction, something that causes them to go to another part of it, kind of like Apollo 13, like take refuge over here. So something, an image of the International Space Station. And I didn't get real deep into that. That was just fleeting, came and went, grabbed it. And one more fleeting little tagging thing is this guy. See if I can draw him like I saw him. I'm not a very good artist, but I just let it go. I just let my hands show me what I saw, and that actually kind of looks like him. Charlie Manson. Now, I know Charlie Manson was in the news a month, 90 days, not 90, a month or two ago. He was real sick, and so this may not be a really profound remote viewing prediction, because we know he's nearing the end of his life. But I saw him when I was working this, and I saw him walking, and it looked like a newsreel footage of him. It does kind of look like him. Charlie Manson. More news about him. Probably passing away would be my feel of what this is going to be. So, water event. Space Station News, Charles Manson. So moving on now to something a little more formally, a little more in-depth work in 2HHM-2NHB. Land gestalt, roaring, rushing sounds, smells of wet, damp, muddy, mucky. Temperatures are cool, and the texture is wet, muddy, oozing ground that's saturated, wet, mucky, muddy. I can also see some structures. One in particular is shaped kind of like this, like a bridge or a conduit, something arching like this, that with a, I don't know what the word is, stuff flows through it, but there's definitely stuff flowing through it now. I see people. And I see water. So gestalts of land, structures, people, and something up above that I'll get into with sounds of jet engine helicopter noise, roaring, smells of jet fuel, kerosene, jet fuel, jet exhaust, hot exhaust. This is in motion, and this is hard. I'm calling it like a helicopter above this. So given that my gestalts are land, this object or structure, water, several people gestalts, I'm going to look at these one by one. So let's isolate land. And the way I'm seeing this land is I get a very survey type look at this, a big overview, like a large area of many, many square miles, tens of, even hundreds of square miles, a big, vast area that I'm seeing, with mountains in the distance, several creeks, streams, rivers coming down out of the mountains, lower areas that would be foothills, and then a broader plain and farmland below. So I'm seeing a pretty vast area in this land. Let me try to get a little closer. Like a floodplain, and there is flooding. I see water. I see land with water encroaching, rising. You know, the classic pictures of bridges and freeways that disappear under water. I get people fleeing injury. I'll get to the people a little bit more, but this is definitely flood type stuff. Land is oversaturated, can't hold any more water. When more water comes, there's nowhere for it to go. People spreading out. Looking at that, like helicopter, okay? This thing is, yeah, I smell jet fuel and exhaust from it. I hear the loud engine roar. I see it hovering above the land. There's a lot of activity. Actually, there's a bunch of these working in concert. So I drew this one, but this is not the only one. There's like a fleet of them. They're coming and going. They're doing all kinds of different things. They're search and rescue, relief supplies. So there are some that are looking, seeing things, reporting back. There's one that is dropping stuff, dropping life-saving material, food care packages, flotation devices, and then like baskets to pull people up and rescue them. So a lot going on, these things hovering, and I can see the downdraft of the rotors stirring up water. So there's, you know, water going from the downdraft of the rotors. I get a good visual of that. So helicopters in a relief, rescue, search and rescue, relief and recovery effort. All those things, rescue, relief, recovery. Looking at the people, no wait, there's a structure I want to look at before I get to the people. When I look at this particular structure, I feel very enclosed. I feel like this is a, it's like cavernous, like a channel, like a pipe, aqueduct type of, I don't get the exact name, but it's curving, it's underground, it's enclosed, it's big, and I see it filled with like water, flowing water. So this is rising catastrophically. I get a sense of power being out, bad things happening, and too much. I don't know if this is like a relief valve type of thing or an emergency bypass, but a lot of water in it and not good things happening. Okay, now to Now to the people. I can see people. They're like holding on to something. They feel like in a precarious place, like a sense of waiting for rescue, being surrounded, panicked, clutching, shouting, yelling. There are acts of heroism. There are people helping other people. There are people in a bad situation, and some are just freaking out. Some are, all are afraid for their life. Some are doing heroic things. And by the way, these people are, some of them thigh deep, some of them waist deep, some of them chest deep, some of them different depth, different people, a lot of different people. But survivors, rescuers, people dying, and I'll get to that in a minute, but a lot of people, and a lot of people, the sense of being trapped, surrounded, wanting to get out, looking for help, needing help, acts of heroism that will be recorded and told. And then other looks at people I see. These look to me like body bags stacked up. I see law enforcement guarding over them, watching, but there's nothing they can do for these people at this point. They're being awaiting transport. They've been, this is outdoors, this isn't in a morgue, this is in a natural setting. Be like the medical examiner would be pulling up, and a bad scene with some deaths and body bags stacked up and law enforcement officials kind of guarding the remains type of thing, keeping people away. And one more look at land. And the water is, I see neatly arrayed, like this, like agricultural cropland where you can see roads and dividing areas. And then the water has come up, and it's invading, it's intruding, and it's reclaiming. You know, I just feel this is a flood event. I don't know about that. You know, that dam, which one was it? Was it called Oroville? I don't know if I cannot spell when I, the big dam in California that they had it, it was the emergency thing was coming and then the emergency ended. I don't think the emergency's over. I think we're going to. I think it might involve that, but I'm not sure. So that's my look at March. We will see.
For my first target, I have coordinates 0285-2228. Seems it's a type of energetic of some sort. Let me see what's going on here. I have a lot of chaos, a lot of movement, a lot of energy. I'm having cold, wet snow. Water mix, it smells very salty, kind of like a beach, but but it's really cold here. A lot of cloud dynamics, a lot of things whirling. There's a city surrounding like a large body of water. So you'll see the buildings and you see the large body of water, more buildings. Mountains, steep peaks of some sort. It's really salty. The air is salty, like the beach. I'm kind of seeing this everywhere. Goodness. Okay, this is sort of what I'm seeing here. I do a smaller version of it just so I can explain it. It looks like this. It's a whole lot of white going or mist or wet going around. It's kind of in a circular motion. It reminds me of a tornado, but it's, I don't think it's from the clouds. Can't necessarily blizzard, like a lot of snowstorms. You hear a lot of rushing sounds, you see a lot of things going every which way, lots of activity, lots of It's kind of everywhere. White, rain, sleet, snow, wind, like a hurricane, but with snow. It's a lot of activity. You can sense there's something not located on a surface that I'm picking up here. Well, this isn't on the surface, actually. A lot of activity in the air. I'm in the air looking down at things. I can see it's just out of control. Completely out of control. Let me see the city or place where I am. What was it? 325-228. I've got. So I have this city, again, like I said, surrounding water. There's some type of, it's frozen, or it's not necessarily frozen, it's close to frozen. It's really cold. It kind of reminds me of the Day After Tomorrow movie, where it's just ice and snow everywhere in a very unusual place. This type of weather is unusual for where we are right now. There's a lot of confusion, a lot of energetics. That picture I drew first kind of goes on top of that. So it's like that whole cycle is on top of this. Very abnormal for this place anyways. Very cold for this place. It's a natural disaster. The subjects are in dismay. They're really confused. They seem they're trying to get to somewhere safe. I'm seeing an aircraft. Or some sort. It's in the sky. There's subjects in it, so I'm assuming it's an aircraft. They're terrified, and it seems to be going out of control. I'm gonna draw a odd shape because I don't know how to draw an airplane. All right, looks like a fish, but that's my airplane. Has people in there, they're terrified. They seem to be going out of control, seem to be whirling along with the weather and there's a crash site somewhere along the city over here. When you're looking, you see smoke. You see smoke coming from the city. It might not be that much, but there's smoke coming from the city. I can't explain it. I have to draw it. It's very. And then you have people. You have people rushing, it looks like towards where the crash site is. You have people are hurt, harmed. It looks that way. People are confused. People are trapped. There's snow blocking doors. People can't get out of their homes. Piles and piles of snow, smoke, fire. It looks like this smoke. There's some color here. Red, oranges. What looks like fire from, I'm guessing, the explosion. So these two places must be close because you see the storm. Okay, so this storm has done some damage to this place. People are hurt. People are scared. People are terrified. People are confused. because it's not supposed to happen here. It's not like this anyways. For my second target, I am doing coordinates 5074-2392. I have a lot of natural land. They're very irregular hills or mountains. They're definitely rather steep. A lot of natural smells. I feel like I'm in a very natural environment, but I do see structures like a village, a city, town type thing. It's not necessarily what we call urban. There's many subjects or few. There's enough subjects to know that there's something going on here. There's a lot of foliage, bright lights. I hear shouting. I hear roaring. I hear loud. It's quite loud. Let me draw this for you. Okay, I have this little green hilly village of some sort. It's very, very green. You see a lot of subjects rushing towards whenever it looks like it's this area here. Smokes, clouds of smoke coming from, what's with all this smoke here? Clouds of smoke. It looks as though this forest here may be on fire or something has happened in this area. People are rushing towards it. People are rushing from it. Pretty chaotic. I guess that's why I hear a loud roaring. It's a possible fire. So there's foliage. It's a small little town. It's not much. It's not in New York. It's not in Atlanta. It's not a San Francisco or California. It's none of that. It's very secluded. It's a place you don't hear much about, but or at least I don't hear much about. Some running water coming from the hills, and it does appear to have some flamage, some flames going on within this fire here, possible fire. Looking back into, this is pretty quiet, and if I go back into time, you just see the town. There's not much going on here. It's really quiet, but currently it's very chaotic. It's a lot of rushing. People are confused a little bit. People are moving like super fast. Cars are moving super fast. They're very upset about what's going on here in their town. Something something caused this. And you can kind of see, you can kind of see damaged things, debris of some sort. I'm not sure if it's from the trees or from the buildings. Let me see, kind of see if I can see where I am. Very fair-skinned people, dark hair. They're visibly upset. They're very visibly upset. Their language is, the accent is different, but they're speaking English. It's not a different language, but it is different voices. Very slim people. It seems to be the way that, you know, that they are there. Looking after this event has happened, it's very gloomy. You can see clouds of gray, so I'm guessing it's from the smoke. You kind of smell the smoke a little bit too. The day after all this has happened, and it's kind of sad almost. You can feel the emotion of the people here. It's not much else really going on here besides this particular little event here, and people just seem a bit out of it, a bit sad or whatnot, or just a tiny little green village, or I guess they wouldn't call it a village, a green town here.
Hi, my name is Aziz, and today we will be looking at target 2412-3852. This target represents a session that was conducted in February of 2017 and predicts an event that will occur in March of 2017. Feeling a vertical surface. It feels metallic and almost feels like it has more of an angle to it. The base surface seems like it is wet, watery. There seems to be more angular structures on the top here. The whole thing seems very metallic. Hard, solid metals. The general environment I'm seeing seems to be sort of like a landmass here that sort of tapers off, and pretty much extensive water just going off in the distance. And sort of this landmass just sort of way out in the back, just sort of seen in the background. I'm getting some sense of a few subjects here on the metal area. Let's try to see if we can get a better idea as of the shape. Is it more of a structure, or is it like a boat or something? So let's look at that. Okay, so I'm once again getting this angular sense. So I'm tempted to say that it's more of a boat-shaped structure. And from the front, yeah, from the front it seems more narrow and a little like a rounded cone at the bottom of it. Same angular structures up at the top. And same watery base surface below. So, boat-shaped structure or vehicle on a wet base surface. So let's look and see what those subjects were sort of looking like. Okay, I'll draw what I'm seeing as one of the subjects. Okay, so, a male subject seems to be having this uniform that he's got on and barking an order in a direction. It seems like his skin is a much lighter color than his uniform. His skin seems definitely black hair. His skin seems sort of maybe olive colored or Asian looking, but a light skin tone, like a tan it with a little color, but it's mainly a lighter skin tone. And just wearing this dark textile, like synthetic textile looking uniform, it sort of seems like it sort of reminds me of kind of like a Navy uniform would be, but like a cross between that and sort of like a worker's uniform. So he's got headgear on, but it's not hard. It's not like a helmet. It seems more like a cap. But yeah, that's what this first subject looks like. Let's look at a different one. Okay, so I labeled this one S1 and this one here S2. S2 seems like he's more in a position to be barking orders at S1 over here, who, if you can visualize where they are, let's say like if this is a flat area, here's S2 is right here, and S1 is right here, and he's sort of saying stuff, and S1, I put exclamation marks over S1's head because it seems like S1 is responding to some sort of situation, sort of like a jostling, a wide-eyed, like, you're talking to me type of thing. S2, let's go inside. So it seems like S2 is more of in an authoritative position. He seems a little bit stockier, like a little bit more of a portly person. He's not big, but you know, he's bigger than S1 is all I'm saying. He sort of seems like he's in this, taking charge, do this, prepare for that, make this happen. So it seems like this person's telling S1, S2 is telling S1 what to do. Or barking orders in the direction of S1 from my perspective. So it seems like both of them have this perspective of looking at this vehicle that they're on as a thing to focus on. That seems like what the big deal is doing stuff on the boat-shaped craft that's in a watery base surface. So let's look more into S1. What's going on with him? So S1 is a bit more tense, a bit more like on edge. I wouldn't really say worried, but like a little worried, but like more uncertain and following and unsure of the situation. That's a good way to describe it. Feeling uncertainty, unsure, but doing what he's told. Again, both are male subjects. So doing what he's told, and both of them seem to have this attention towards the equipment and the machinery around them and the structures going on. But S1 seems to be thinking about, I don't know, like something else. S1 seems to be focusing in on something larger. So let's look around and see what could be around the structure that's going on. What's the main event happening here? Okay, so we're going to move a mile up and see if what we can observe from up there. Okay, so what I'm getting here is what really looks like several of these similar shaped structures on a watery base surface. So let me see if I can draw them the way I see them. Okay, so it seems to me like there is these main three boat-like structures. They all seem similar, but looking closely, they all are a little different in terms of what the details sort of look like where equipment seems to be and the slight color and shape of what they are. But I'd say this one is a bit fatter, and this one a bit more narrow, and this one also is a little bit more similar to this one. But we'll just call this one Object 1, Object 2, Object 3. So it seems like from the position that I'm looking at it here, Object 2 and Object 3 are looking at Object 1. Object 1 has its attention on Object 2 and Object 3, but I also noticed this little thing over here, and it seems like we could maybe call this Object 4, but it's way out there. It's not close. It's just way out in the distance. The main show is happening here between Objects 1, 2, and 3. So let's move out and see what we can just turn to gaze. I'm getting this faint sense like there might be like a piece of land, but that's way out there, really far from where these guys are, but it's visible. It's just way out there. So it's not close to where these guys are. It's just way out in the distance. Way too far to swim or anything like that. So, I mean, these guys aren't exactly next to each other either. It's just These guys are closer together than any of them are to this landmass over here, and this other guy, Object 4, is a significant distance in an opposite direction, too. So, let's see. I'm getting this feeling of there's multiple subjects on each of these objects, and some of the subjects seem to be moving a lot more quickly. They seem to be a bit more hectic. Other ones seem to be in this, like, half of them observing, the other half doing a little bit of work, but it seems like they all have this sense of tension between each other that's sort of just like a standoff, like they're waiting for something. So that's a bit weird, but anyway, anything else? All right, so finally, let's go through time. Let's see, 24 hours there, 24 hours here, 24 hours in the past. Seems like weather's a little bit cloudier, but none of these guys are here, so it's gone. 24 hours in the future. It seems like these guys aren't there, but these two are further back. I'm not saying these guys just, like, left completely. They're not in the frame in which I'm looking at anymore, but these two seem to have moved further back. So, I can only really notice these two, and they've moved from this position further backwards, and that seems to be what I'm looking at here. The other two sort of went someplace else. All right, well, that concludes the data that I've got for target 2412-3852. Hi. Now we will be looking at target 0967-5873. Again, this is a target that was focused on an event that will be happening in March of 2017, and the session took place solo under blind conditions in February of 2017. Okay, so a lot of upward rushing energetics, but it's gritty, like sand, like a sandstorm going vertically. I'm picking up a subject, and let me see if I can depict the subject. Okay, so it seems like we've got a male subject here who's got a real tough protective piece of headgear right here, like a real tough, light-colored, hard helmet-like piece of headgear. And he seems like he's got a lot of protection, I mean, eye gear, and fully clothed in what seems to be just like workers' clothes. So I'm not quite sure if it's a uniform or not, but regardless, he's standing on a hard base surface that seems to be metallic, like a metal scaffold kind of thing. Like it's metal, but it's not like real thick, hard, solid metal. It's just sort of like a ledging type of thing. And all of this brown stuff is like debris that I see just flying upwards at this guy. And his arms are up, sort of like he's taken aback by this. So let's sort of, we'll call him S1. And let's go inside and see what S1 is experiencing at this time. So, S1's mind is almost blank. It's like shock and surprise. So, sort of like all room for thoughts just went away. It's just sort of like this happened, and just everything is running on instinct up there. So, just real crushing vibrations going through the guy, like this huge booming sound going, and it's not quick, it's just going, and he's just not prepared for this. So it sort of seems to be rattling his chest, sort of pushing it inwards, and this really intense reaction to whatever is shooting all of this brownish, light brownish, blackish material upwards. So, yeah. Let's see if we can zoom out and see a better picture of what's going on here. Okay, so as I zoom out further, it seems like there's this natural base surface that's encompassing a large piece of area. And a slight irregular topography that I can see. Not much, just a little hill-looking structure, so. And here there's just this massive expulsion of material just shooting upwards. But it almost seems like there's this metallic structure right here next to it. So I'll draw this in. It's weird, it's like this metallic man-made structure inside this area of majority natural topography. And this huge burst of what feels like natural materials, sort of just like the earth is exploding upwards, just dirt and dust and sand and rocks just shooting upwards right next to this man-made structure. So that is present with that subject that we drew earlier, that subject that was there and not prepared for what this was happening. Okay, so to sort of get an idea of what could have caused this, let's look 24 hours into the future and 24 hours into the past and see what's happening. So, okay, so 24 hours into the past, I'm getting this feeling that there is, again, natural base surface adjacent to a structure. Not quite sure if it's as big as it seemed in the first one, but adjacent to some man-made thing. And it seems like there's, at the very least, 2 to 3 subjects outside working. Okay, so I'm seeing these three subjects. They're surrounded by these man-made pieces of equipment. I don't know, technology, just tools. And they all seem to have these hard hats. They're really tough headgear. And so, I don't know if it's like a plasticky thing with like a cloth on it or just plastic. It's just hard plasticky. I don't know, it's just tough. It's protecting their head. But they have this equipment that's around them as well. And let's see what's going on inside one of their heads. So let's call it, that other guy was S1, so let's call this person S2. And let's go inside S2's head. Okay, so S2 seems to be a lot calmer than S1. S2 seems to be in this more mundane work, do this, do that, no big deal type of vibe with him. Seems to be serious about his work. I mean, he's not being lazy, he's calculating, it's a male. And just his perspective just seems to be focused on the equipment in front of him. And let's see these people. Yeah, I can say the same for pretty much all of them. They're all just working on this stuff that's in front of them, doing whatever that is that they're doing, and calculating things. I mean, whatever they're doing, their attention is on the equipment before them. And they're not too worried about whatever happens the next day. So, if they know about it. Okay, 24 hours into the future this time. Wow, okay, so there seems to be this different shaped, but similar metal structure. It just seems to be moved, or I don't know, it just looks a little different. Metal structure, but instead of being adjacent to a blast, it seems to be adjacent to It seems to be adjacent to a crater, or like a hole, or something. So, it just seems to be this deep crater into the earth. It's almost like from this period, there was this people working here, and they're, all right, this happens, and then the next day, there's just this huge crater inside the earth, and it almost is like, based on the content of stuff that was flying into the air the day before, it seems like that just the earth itself was ripped out of the ground and shot upwards into the sky. I mean, there's still like this, I definitely felt like this a lot of loose dirt just sort of like lying around here. But it's almost as if, like, some force just blew all of the earth out of the ground in this sort of cone-ish type of shape and just shot it up into the air. And this thing probably had something to do with it. But it's a man-made metallic structure with people with hard hats on for safety reasons and safety equipment. They were working in a natural area on something and using some sort of equipment. Whatever happened with them being there, The Earth was ripped out of the ground and shot into all sorts of directions, but mostly just vertically shot up. And the result was a giant crater left next to the altered structure that was there the day before. And that concludes the data for target 0967-5873.
So that is the news for March 2017, brought to you at the end of February 2017. Remember that we rely on published news to verify these predictions as we go through the month of March. Now, to help with this, we publish a news analysis table on our website, updated daily, that relies on both the featured news outlets of the CNN, the New York Times, and the BBC, as well as other news outlets that may cover important stories that are not covered by our featured news outlets. Now remember, we at the Farsight Institute have also used remote viewing in many of our Mysteries projects, and we just released a major Mysteries project on the Roswell UFO crash that is a must-see. Now we also have published other Mysteries projects covering topics as diverse as the 9/11 attacks, the JFK and Martin Luther King Jr. assassinations, and the psychology of Adolf Hitler, as well as topics involving UFOs and extraterrestrial life on Mars, in Cydonia, the Phoenix Lights, and even what appears to be an ancient alien resort facility on Iapetus, a moon of Saturn. Now, these Mysteries projects are cutting-edge science, and they are absolutely spellbinding. Also, when you watch them, you help us pay the bills for our Time Cross project. So please go to our website and watch one or more of our Mysteries projects. In addition, we publish a Farsight vlog on our Farsight Press YouTube channel. Now, the vlog addresses all sorts of topics relating to remote viewing. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and keep up with the latest. And again, please try to watch our results summaries as well as the raw news reports each month. Those are two separate videos each month for our Time Cross project that you will need to watch. Now, let's watch the news for March 2017 to see how well we did with our remote viewing news predictions. Remember, we don't pick the targets, we just report them the month before they happen. Also, please consider contributing to the Farsight Institute by going to our website and clicking on the donate graphic. Every bit helps. We have no corporate or governmental sponsors. Everything we do is because of people who help. People just like you. And if you are fluent in other languages, we can always use volunteers to help translate our videos so we can reach a greater worldwide audience. Check out the links in the description area below this video. And right now, please subscribe, like, and share this video. Help us spread the word. Stay ahead of the curve. Let the mainstream fade in the dust. Be there now.